I've been making a burger every day until Mike made that response, and that's because 4 months ago, Mike promised to respond to my DM.
You have my word. Otherwise, you could show your viewers that I'm a fucking
thank you.
But he never did. After months of making burgers and millions of views on TikTok, I kind of came to the conclusion that he just wasn't going to respond. Then one day, he finally responded, agreeing to make a burger with me. But then he ghosted me. So I took a leap of faith, and I booked a one-way ticket to LA, and I'm not coming back until I get that video. I financially support my whole family, and to be honest, I can't really afford this. But sometimes you just gotta grab life by the balls and say fuck it.
Oh, can I tell you something?
Why ain't trying to just be cool? We gotta make history.
After Mike stopped replying to my emails, I started paying close attention to his social media. I knew he lived in LA, and the plan was to go there and see if I could still convince him to make the video. The problem was he was always away from home traveling. So when I knew he was in LA for sure, I had to get there as soon as possible. Bear in mind, I live in Australia and the minimum flight time is 14 hours. So by the time I get there, he could have already left. And then one day he posted this, a photo of his backyard, which means he was at home. Keep it a stack. Bitches move walk cause they know I got beans. They be chatting, I don't give a damn. Once I got there, I tried every method of contacting him I could. I emailed him, I sent him a DM, I even made a story and tagged him in it.
Hey Mike, it's me. You said that potentially you were down to make the burger video with me, and then I don't know what happened. I'm in LA. If there's any chance we can still make it happen, I'm around.
And it worked. But he didn't respond.
Can you at least say no? Not saying anything is like the most depressing thing in the world.
It's too early for this shit. But I'm probably down to do something later. I couldn't fucking believe it. On the first day, he'd already agreed to make a video with me. I went back to my hotel and just waited to hear from Mike. And then the worst thing that could possibly happen.
Yo, brother, I'm going to Miami literally right fucking now. I have to leave my house. So, I mean, yeah, if you came to Miami, I will have time to do it. And then after that, I won't be available.
So it gave me two options. One, I could fly to Miami, or I could hang around and wait until he potentially would come back to LA. And obviously, there was only one answer. I can't be told no handguns unless the bitch come with a thud. I can't be fucking the moment I landed in Miami, I sent him a text asking when he'd be free. By then, I'd been awake for 27 hours. I was so tired, but I couldn't go to sleep. I was worried that Mike might text me last minute saying that he was ready. And if that happened, I'd be asleep and I'd miss my one opportunity. Then, after months of making burgers, millions of views on TikTok, flying halfway around the world, I finally got the text saying that he was ready.
I want to say this first, before anything else. I'm doing this because you put a lot of effort in, bro. I saw all the TikToks. You came to LA.
Yeah.
You didn't do anything stupid. Like, people like to do stupid shit, like show up at my house. And I said, yo, I'm down to meet up with you. And then I didn't end up having time, and I came to Miami. And you fucking came here, and were respectful, and you waited till I was ready. So that's why we're doing this. If you were some kid that was like, yo, let me be your intern, bro, I would have never fucking came. And that's why I'm here.
Exactly what I led with.
I left you for free.
Obviously, we're gonna make a burger. As well as that, I got Australian snacks for him to try. Crocodile jerky, kangaroo jerky, and Vegemite. Then we're gonna put Mike to the test by doing a blind taste test between Prime and Gatorade. And he has to tell me which one is Prime. But there's a catch. They're both Gatorade. Mike loves Prime, so he'll definitely know that they're both Gatorade, right?
Bro, I'm telling you right now, I'm not eating crocodile. I can't, dude.
I haven't eaten either.
Excited about? That smells so bad. And dude, I'm normally not a bitch. Like, I'm normally trash. So just fucking give it to me. Give it. Oh. I don't want it.
What are you? Just making sure that I'm
like, poisoned. Oh, fair enough.
Last time Mike tried Vegemite, he didn't exactly like it.
So salty. Bro, it's like eating fucking seawater.
I cannot eat this.
No. Trust me. Sorry, I'm gonna toast two pieces of bread. When you looked me in the eyes,
yeah,
and I didn't ask you to,
right?
You chose to look me in the eyes,
yeah,
and swear to me, yeah, that you're gonna reply to my DM.
I'll answer.
Okay.
You have my word. Otherwise, you could show your viewers that I'm a fucking.
Thank you.
Well, did I reply to your DM?
No.
But did I reply to your DM?
After like 5 million views.
Okay. Did I say I was gonna reply to your DM by X date, or did I say I was gonna reply to your DM? I don't know if you know this, but I'm a little busy.
Down to one piece of bread.
Put that back on. Okay. I'll eat desperate. Bro, I used to smoke crack.
That's all right. Yeah, bro, this is normally like, I cook the burgers on here, it's like normally hot.
Was it on? Throw a tiny piece of butter on there, I wanna see what happens. This is the feedback that I got last time, that there was way too much Vegemite on it.
Bro, it's like eating f***ing seawater.
This is the way the Aussies told me to have it, so here we go. Way better.
Okay, you could try some.
David, it tastes delicious. There was just too much. But just a little kick of salt.
Yes! Besides, it actually tastes like something.
Yeah, Vegemite.
This is the moment I've been waiting for. Mike is the founder and CEO of his own burger chain. He's tasted burgers from all around the world. This was my one shot to make the perfect 10 out of 10 burger for Mike Mailer.
Okay, smash patty.
With a plate?
Oh, fuck, bro. Oh, fuck. We're starting again.
Oh.
Okay, that's a smash patty.
Oh, my God. Does it sound right?
Nah.
No, from like, no. Is it hot enough, you think?
No.
Even though the grill wasn't even remotely hot enough, somehow we still managed to make a burger.
Bro, I like that you're sticking with this, bro.
If I gave up now,
yeah,
that would be like, you could diagnose me with like some kind of Down syndrome.
Might still be able to be honest, even if you keep going. I'm gonna be honest, dude, the way you made that Vegemite toast really, really said a lot about you, bro.
Good or bad?
No, it was fantastic.
You started asking me if I was like mentally okay.
You doing therapy and stuff? Or managing your back? No, I just wanted to make sure that I said you just need to check in with yourself, you know, from every now and again.
Sure.
You're Middle Eastern?
Bro, what do you think I was?
Australian.
Is that like, can you be Australian? Like, no one's American. Like.
Yeah, same as Australia.
Now the moment we've all been waiting for.
When do I get to have the burger?
This guy's like, oh bro, how many like bites does it take?
It's science.
Not fair enough.
Right? It's fucking science.
All right, all right.
For a hotel room burger, It's really not that bad. 4.8.
Oh, what the fuck? You said it's not bad.
No, it's not. It's not bad, dude. Bro, you cooked it over ridiculously low heat in a hotel room using pretty old meat.
No, I put that. That's the point today.
It's fucking gray. The meat is, David, confirm the color on that meat, dude.
It's gray.
It's gray, okay?
I think that's the light sauce, reflecting.
It's, I don't know if I like the spice that you put in the sauce.
Damn, white guy doesn't like spices. I mean, I'm just saying.
The Vegemite toast, 8.2.
So
delicious.
Would you recommend Vegemite?
Mm-hmm.
Honestly, after getting an American to like Vegemite, I should be considered for Australian of the Year. Now we're gonna find out how much Mike actually likes Prime. I told him one cup has Gatorade and one cup has Prime, and all he has to do is tell me which one the Prime is. But the catch is, they're both Gatorade.
Bro, that's the easiest thing in the entire world. If I fail this right now, it's a wrap, bro. It's so easy, though.
Looks exactly the same.
Bro, I don't even have to try it.
You sure about that, Mike?
Wait, you tell me, without even trying, tell me.
The right one's the Prime.
Yeah.
You know that
yeah.
for sure.
Yeah.
As a fact. Okay, drink it and then tell me that's Prime.
Yeah, this is the Prime.
Are you 100% sure?
100% sure.
You'd be willing to put like money on that?
Yeah.
They're both Gatorade.
I don't believe you.
It's a placebo, right?
Yeah, it is. He talked to me.
Prime bottle is full.
He's right.
And this one?
Try the Prime.
This is definitely Gatorade.
Oh, you can't say that.
Honestly,
that's way
too late.
Placebo.
It's weird. The brain's weird, dude.
Okay, if you want to try that.
That's crazy.
It is so drastically different. What I was doing, I was measuring the one that had more taste, and that was gonna be the Prime. If he had done that with Blue, I would have got it.
I'm telling you.
No, if the Gatorade Prime part makes it in, make sure the second part of it where we talk about mind control goes in. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, sure.
Then I gave Mike potentially the most awkward hug of all time.
Bro, listen, you did what you had to do. You fucking stayed consistent.
Yeah.
So that's why I came. Go with God, my friend. I'll see you in Australia. Peace out.
Thank you so much.
Guys, I can't thank you enough. The fact that everyone actually got behind it and so many people tagged Mike is the only reason this happened. Subscribe, because I got some big plans coming up for this channel.